so much for coming out on this wonderfully not dry evening out here. My name is Paul Roberts, and I am the drama instructor here at Kellogg High School. And I am thrilled. I said to the kids upstairs, this is a show 4 years in the making. For the last 4 years, I have been working with these kids, and it's been a wonderful group to get to work with. So I want to start off by first of all thanking them tonight. We're going to have a great time. I also want to make sure some thank yous. I'll say thank you to Mr. Miller for the Wildcats Live. I'm on TV. Hi, Mom. somehow you will be able to have access to this later on YouTube should you wish to. Another thing that I want to make sure that that we take care to mention is March 10th, vote.
Yes.
Vote. Also, let's talk about your phones tonight. These are all short selections. Oftentimes, if we have a copyrighted play that we're doing that whole play, we say to you, please be careful with copyright. These are small sections that we are allowed to use for competition. And so the copyright is different. If you choose to take some pictures, we're okay with that tonight. We just hope that they're not flash pictures so that they don't shock us when you do that. But that would be appropriate for you to do that at this time. Our show tonight lasts for about an hour, so there won't be any intermission. Once we get going, we will just continue right on through. Our show tonight is a collection of solo and ensemble selections featuring, and I will bring them out at this point, Mr. Jordan Grubbs. Jocelyn McGregor. Competition, and three of these were state qualifiers for us. We're going to give you a taste of what our competitions look like by having the performers introduce most of these pieces that you are going to see tonight. Not all competition pieces are serious, so we do a lot of comedy, but tonight we have an intense performance for you with all serious performances, but I know that you are going to enjoy this, and so I think I've covered everything I'm supposed to cover. With that, I believe that we are ready. We're ready.
Who have more fun with him. Are you mad? Why haven't you gotten back to me? Hello? Are you with Jake? Where are you? Why are you ignoring me? Why are you doing this to me? I still have the pills you told me to get rid of. I'm gonna do it!
Hey, I'm so sorry. My phone died. I didn't bring my charger to school. Are you okay? Can you please call me when you get this? Hey, did you get any of my messages? I'm so sorry.
If you're sorry, why don't you send a picture that'll cheer me up?
I'm at dinner with my family.
You can run to the bathroom.
I don't know, maybe later?
Not now. You owe it to me.
I don't think I can.
Are you breaking up with me? Sometimes I need you. You're the only person I care about. I bet you never even love me. If you break up with me, I'll kill myself.
Ever? Then how do you know what happened to me? Has it ever happened to you? I didn't think
that piece of paper a little bit better. I had everything anyone could ever want. A loving husband, a beautiful house, wonderful children. I had my two little twins, Maggie and Betty. They could brighten up the worst of days. Then came the fire. It all happened so fast, it seems like a dream. I wish it were a dream that I wouldn't have this pain of letting them go and realizing that they're gone forever because of me. I found the girls upstairs playing with box matches. I took the matches and hit them. I know I did. But I must have missed one. We all went down for naps that day, and I actually fell asleep, which is weird because I never sleep during the day. I woke up to my oldest daughter, Susan, screaming and crying. I opened my eyes to see that her blonde hair was black. What happened? My bed is on fire, she screamed. I leapt out of bed and I ran to the phone. George, this is your sister, Sarah. Get over here right now. My house is on fire and I think Maggie and Betty are trapped upstairs. I hung up the phone and I ran for the stairs. On my way up, the stairs collapsed. And I fell, breaking my arm. And I kept trying to get out of there and up to my babies, but I couldn't get out with only one good arm. Then George appeared and pulled me up. He dashed after the girls, but he didn't make it much farther than I did before the stairs collapsed on him as well. He broke both his ankles. I could hear the girls screaming and crying. It broke my heart, but I realized now that that was music to compare to my ears and then compared to what I heard next. Silence. When the girls stopped crying, I knew the fire had gotten them. I was incredibly depressed. I started screaming like I was crazy. I screamed their names, making them to start crying again. Anything to let me know that they were still alive. But I never heard them cry again. Now, is that crazy, Doctor? What is crazy? Define crazy. Is crazy losing your children to a fire that you could have prevented just by checking the floor or their pockets for that one little match you missed? Or by explaining to them a little bit better about how dangerous it is to play with fire? Is that crazy? No, but do you know what is? They found the bodies of my babies behind the furnace. The furnace! I didn't even think a rat could fit behind that furnace, but there they were, huddled together, with their arms wrapped around each other, trying to protect each other from the flames. Why? Why not me? They weren't even 3 years old! I am old! I've lived long enough! Why did God take away two children if he loves them so much? I know what you're thinking now. You think I'm crazy. But what is crazy? When is crazy? Why do you think you can tell people they're crazy? How do you define crazy? Now, who's crazy, Doctor? Me or you? It's not me, Doctor. So it must be you.
City. are you, sweetie?
Hot.
You look terrific.
I look terrible, you know. Ugh, you're all wet.
I don't smell too good either.
Yeah, you smell great to me.
Well, at the risk of losing my animal magnetism, I'm gonna go take a shower.
Not yet, I'm afraid.
Don't tell me. Matt hasn't fixed the showers.
He just went into town to pick up the faucets.
I could have done that. I'm not paying him $9 an hour to go run errands. You've got to stay on top of these things.
I told him.
Look, fix me a scotch, will you? A large one. If I can't get clean, at least I can get intoxicated enough not to care.
There's no ice. The refrigerator's out yet.
Have you checked the fuses?
No. I didn't know which was which.
It's not a scientific mystery, Jenny. All you have to do is check them one by one. The light's not working down there either. How many things have you been trying to run off this poor electrical system today?
Everything.
You're overloading, you know that?
Yes, but...
Then don't be surprised when the fuses blow.
I'm not. Not the least bit surprised.
Don't be rude. Where's the flashlight?
In one of those boxes. Who's the little girl?
What?
The little girl.
Jenny, which box?
This one. Who is she?
What little girl?
One out of the street.
Here it is. She must have run off. What a mess. When are we going to get sorted out? I can't find anything. I went to work with two different colored socks on this morning.
I'm trying, Richard. There's just so much to do.
It was a question of organization, Jenny. That's all. I thought this was your forte. 1 month ago, you were holding down a job as managing editor. Surely you're not going to let a small farmhouse get the best of you.
Small? Small? This is a large farmhouse, Richard, and every room is full of old furniture and boxes of junk. I've got workmen repairmen stomping their way through every 5 minutes. The refrigerator keeps breaking down. The toilets keep backing up. There are trunks and suitcases and crates all over the place. And how long have we been here? 4 weeks. 4 whole weeks, and I'm not organized yet. You know, Richard, if I were you, I'd fire me. I really would.
Okay, look. I've had one hell of a day, all right? I'm ready for a shower and a cold drink. Is that too much to ask?
It wasn't my idea to move in before the renovation was finished.
If we'd waited till everything was finished, we would have been in that apartment till Christmas.
How would it have been so bad?
What was that?
Nothing.
No, what'd you say?
Richard, this isn't working.
What are you talking about?
This! I'm lonely. I miss my friends. I miss going out, meeting people for a drink when I feel like it. Going to the theater, restaurants. I miss the city, Richard.
But we only just got here.
It's all right for you. You going to work every day. I'm stuck here.
Now, hold on a minute. I didn't drag you into this at gunpoint. This was a decision we made together. You knew what you were getting into.
I wanted to wait, at least until the baby was born.
I had to get you out of there. You wouldn't slow down. You were still putting in 9 hours at the office. Staying at cocktail parties till 3 a.m. The rate you were carrying on, the baby stood a good chance of being born with a cigarette in one hand and a martini in the other. You've got to make up your mind with what you want, because you can't have the best of both worlds.
Well, it's a little late for making choices.
What does that mean? You don't want the baby?
Don't be silly. You know how badly I want it.
Well, then?
It's just... I feel so old to just be starting all this, Richard.
You're hardly over the hill.
I was 20 when I married you. I wanted a baby then.
I know. I wanted a baby then just as much as you did.
Oh, really?
You know I did. Now, Jenny, please, let's not.
You wanted a baby so bad you wouldn't even talk to a doctor.
I'm gonna get out of these clothes.
Hey, where'd you go? I thought of another name. What about Mary? Like in Lazy Mary, will you get up? Will you get up? Will you get up?
got off the phone with Tony. He's coming to visit us.
Really? When?
Tonight.
Tonight?
Yeah, what's wrong?
He'll expect dinner.
Jenny, it's only my brother. We were gonna eat, weren't we? Just do whatever you're gonna do for us. Just make it for four.
Four?
He's bringing his girlfriend.
Oh, no.
Jenny, what's wrong? Since when did last-minute dinner guests throw you off?
Since I've been living 5 miles from the nearest food store? Since my oven, refrigerator, and dishwasher take turns in not working? Since...
Calm down. Listen to me, okay? Tony's getting engaged.
Engaged?
Yes. At last. Can you believe it? She wants to meet his family, and we're all the family he has.
What's her name?
Vicky, or Vicky Bennett.
What's she like?
I don't know. I can tell you something. I don't care. As long as she takes him out of my hands. Jenny, this is very important to her. But if you really can't cope, I'll call him and tell him to make it another night. Now, do you really want me to do that?
No.
I'm
my father's name. This pillow smells funny. It needs washed. I need to wash my hair in the morning.
Did I set the alarm?
Did I lock the door?
Did I turn off the oven?
Did I feed the dog?
You must be the only person still awake at this hour.
Face it, you're never gonna fall asleep.
No, I'm getting closer. I'm having a conversation with myself. That's a good sign, isn't it?
I don't think that's ever a good sign.
My thoughts are jumbling, reality is blurring.
I think if you can comprehend your reality's blurring, it probably isn't.
I'm almost there.
You're gonna leave me alone? Nothing to pull me out, nothing to protect me?
I don't want to be pulled out, I want to be pulled in. It's necessary.
It's scary.
You're a big girl now.
Not when I'm in there.
Nightmares don't count when you're an adult. You can recognize that they can't hurt you.
No, I can't, and yes, they can.
Lucy, you've got to stop doing this. It's not normal.
This isn't fair. I'm with you all the time. You abandon me when I need you most.
I need to rest and regenerate so I can face the world the next day.
When do I get a rest and regenerate? I can never stop. I just keep going like the Energizer Bunny on speed. That's probably why I'm going crazy.
The millionth time, you're not going crazy. Because if you were really going crazy, you wouldn't be asking yourself if you were.
What time is it? Don't look. It'll only make it worse.
I'm going now. I mean it.
I can't face them alone. Can't you come with me?
I don't know how.
Try. Do an exercise.
It won't work.
That beasts are waiting.
They're not real, Lucy.
I need you there to tell me that.
Tell you what?
That it won't be too late.
Lucy, you've gotta let me go, please. I'm so tired.
Guinea pigs and swimming suits. Jello under the rug.
What?
See, I tried to send you off, but you bounced right back by applying logic. You're not ready to go.
Maybe I am losing my mind.
Not yet.
I can't do this!
No, Lucy, yes you can, just... Oceans, clouds, tranquil filter green.
Blackness.
Sheep.
One, two, three. Blind mice.
Coat and king. Knife and life. Stuck in the
fog, mud,
blood.
Don't let the bed bugs
bite. Gnash your teeth. Peace. Flesh. Stressed. Depressed. Rest. Hello? Anyone? Please, can you hear me? Get me out of here! Same person everyone else sees when they look at you. not talking about the mechanics over here. The way the reflection raises its left hand when you raise your right. I'm talking about the persons. When people look at me, they see Rebecca Adams, 17-year-old girl with a punk attitude and a sly smile. But when I look in the mirror, my eyes tear up and I can't see anything at all. Don't look at me like that. You think you know? I can see the words spelling themselves out in your head. Eating disorder, low self-esteem, self-deprecating behavior. But you're wrong. I haven't told you anything yet. You want us to know what I see in the mirror? I see my little brother Jacob. 5 years old, blonde, bowl-cut hair, pudgy face. Classic American kid. Cute, everyone said. Cute. I see a 2003 Mustang car. It's red. The false leather interior. $750 tires. The perfect birthday present for a 16-year-old daughter. It was stupid that I had to pick him up in the first place. I was having the time of my life at the party of the year, and my stupid grandma had stupid other plans, so of course it fell to me to pick him up from the babysitter. I see myself driving down a dark road, shouting at him for things that weren't even his fault. God, the last things I said to him, I screamed to him. He wasn't wearing a seatbelt, and I didn't even care. I was still reeling from a hot time with my boyfriend and 3 shots of Jaeger in my stomach. The tear came out of nowhere. I guess that's what they all say, huh? Came out of nowhere. I mean, really, it came from the bushes on the side of the road. I was just drunk enough that it seemed to have come out of nowhere. And I was still yelling at him the whole time. Every single second of the whole chaotic mess, I look in the mirror and I see myself panic. I watch the whole awful cliche unfold as I see the deer, and my reaction time is just that far off. And then everything goes black. I could look away at this point, but I never do. I always keep watching as the blackness fades. There was my little brother. I see every vivid detail in the mirror. Every single one. They should have charged me with involuntary manslaughter, but they didn't. I don't understand why. They did charge me with driving under the influence. I didn't do community service or anything. They just took my license away and put me in therapy. They didn't even care about the underage drinking. Everyone says that I got off easy as if I'm supposed to be happy or grateful, even proud. Those people are sick. You see this? God, will you put the pen down and listen to me, please? We both know you're getting paid a pretty penny to sit here and listen to me talk about my problems. The least you could do is pretend that you give a... You see the sort of thing happen in the movies, and the friends and family all shy away from the guilty teen. I'm not lucky enough to live that fairy tale. My friends and family are all supportive. They're devastated, but they don't blame me. Why not? It's my fault! Stop looking at me like that! You think you know? You have no idea! You read some books and you watched some films, but that makes you a machine, not a human being! What does that little paper say about me, huh?
experiences extreme emotional outbreaks and intense sensations of guilt. That's what it says, doesn't it? I took psychology sophomore year. I'm not stupid. You just don't get it. No one gets it. Hate is not a strong enough word for how I feel when I look in the mirror. I loathe that reflection. And yet I can't look away. Imagine it was your little brother, or your cousin, or your nephew, or your son, for God's sake. And imagine that he's gone.
Thank you.
then those that have wouldn't. And then you wouldn't. And that's too complicated, so they just keep doing the same old thing. Writing checks, selling change, and making revolution profitable. Corporations own everything anyway. Even our hippie genes, memory cells, and brain. Why doesn't anyone remember anything? And why are rich bad people paid lots of money to give speeches, but poor bad people are tortured or in prison? Is there anyone in charge here, or is this whole thing just spinning out of control until it explodes or dissolves? If there's something we can do, why aren't we doing it? What happened to theory? What happened to accuracy and accountability? What happened to teenagers rebelling instead of buying and selling? What happened to teenagers marching and refusing instead of exploiting and using? I want to touch you in real time, not find you on YouTube. I want to walk beside you in the mountains, not friend you on Facebook. Give me one thing I can believe in that isn't a brand name. I am lonely! I am scared! Girls younger than me are doing things in homeroom and they don't even know it's sex. They just want to be popular. Get some respect. Girls my age are taking pills or not getting out of bed in the morning or eating or starving or getting nose drops or implants or getting cut or Twitter in the way or desperate for a way to be awake without faking to be alive, without freaking to be serious, to be true, to even think of loving someone when we're already doomed. You tell me how to be a girl? I say let's go for it if it's all coming down. I say let's speak it. I say let's fight it, let's write it. There's nothing to hold on to if it's already gone. They left it to us. It sucks, but it's true. It's you and me.
Because they say, I can't tell what's going on in the pantomime. I'm going to give you some hints. Watch for how the music, the sound effects that this group put together, watch how they time those with their movements. It helps tell the story. That's part of the art and the craft of pantomime. Them working together to tell a story is part of what we're watching for. I often say to my students that are getting into pantomime, keep it simple, don't tell too complex of a tale. Yeah, they didn't do that. It's a wonderfully complex tale that's really fun to watch. And then after that, we will have a final in a musical theater. We will finish off our night with this year's state qualifier in musical theater. But right now, we are proud to present to you an original pantomime. Her name is Hope.
Thank you.
Finally, I will be performing Empty Chairs at Empty Tables from the musical Les Miserables.
Thank you. take it that direction.
Oh my gosh.
Both.
Ooh.
You're on TV now.
Okay, that's good.
My jam is over there. I come down to my jam, he's my
chair with it.